two households, both alike in dignity. In fair Verona, where we lay our scene, from ancient grudge break to new mutiny, where civil blood makes civil hands unclean. From forth the fatal loins of these two foes, the pair of star-crossed lovers take their life.
Oh, where is Romeo? Saw you him today?
Right glad I am. He was not at this fray.
Away from the light steals your heavy sun.
My good Benvolio, do you know the cause?
I neither know it nor can learn of him.
See, where he comes. So please you, step aside. I'll know his grievance or be much denied.
Come, madam. Let's away.
Good morrow, cousin! Good morrow, cousin!
Get on with it!
Good morrow, cousin.
Jackson. Is the day so young?
What sadness lengthens Romeo's hours?
I am out of her favor where I am in love. Alas, she is too fair, too wise. Dost thou not laugh?
No, sure. Good Romeo, forget to think of her.
Oh, teach me how I should forget to think. In her beauty
Peace. Our cousin Mercutio draws near.
He jests at scars that never felt a wound.
Children of an idle brain, in the moonshine's watery beams. Through lovers' brains we gather night by night and give them cosmic dreams.
I needed father.
I profane with my unworthiest hand this holy shrine. The gentle sin is this. My lips, two blushing pilgrims ready stand to smooth that rough touch with a tender kiss.
Good pilgrim, you do wrong your hand too much, which mannerly devotion shows in this.
For saints have hands that pilgrims' hands do touch, and palm to palm a
God's holy palms, King.
Stop! What's that to say?
Eric Effiong. Eric Effiong, I need to speak to you.
Adam, I'm over here.
Eric. Something to say to you.
What do you want to say?
I want to hold your hand.
Say it again. Please.
Will you hold my hand?